Hi guys, so this video is one of the videos I said I would make when I did the end of the decade thing. I said there's some new ideas I'm coming up with. This one is one of the sort of more personal ones. It's a bit about drinking and sort of the reasons why I don't drink. So I don't drink an awful lot. I have a little tipple here and there, and I'm not completely teetotal, but there are some things that sort of don't help around certain times of year, and with work. In the job I'm in, being in the public and meeting the public all the time, you sometimes get offered things from customers. So it will be sometimes chocolates. Some people offer you money, you're not allowed to take money, but quite invariably people will offer you bottles of wine, especially around Christmas time, that sort of thing. And so I end up getting usually a collection. Sometimes people buy them as Christmas presents and things like that for me. So I end up with the odd bottle here and there. And I have my nice glass, which I think is very futuristic to drink with. But I don't drink it, and I don't drink wine. And it's not that I don't like wine. It's just that a whole bottle of wine on its own isn't really that much use to somebody. You need to be really with somebody, or be in a group, or as a couple, to drink a bottle of wine. But there is a more significant reason for me, and a more poignant reason, I suppose, is that I don't really drink a lot. I might go out and I'll drink one glass of lager, maybe, or usually a bottle, so it'd be a bottle of something. Normally, like, I will drink a bottle of Beck's normally when I'm out. Sometimes I might drink two bottles. What I won't do is I won't drink wine, and there's a good reason for me not drinking wine, and it's a very simple one, is I had an alcohol problem at the end of the 80s, probably just as I turned 20, or just before I turned 20, I had what I would class as a proper alcohol problem. Now, when I mean by proper alcohol problem, I don't mean like an alcohol problem where you go out with your mates, you get drunk, you muck about, you fool about like an idiot, and spend loads of money you haven't got. That's not really a problem as such, wouldn't I say that? And I'm not on about this sort of problem where you go out with your mates and you drive around looking for lampposts to push over and end up pushing lampposts over after the fifth attempt. That's not the sort of drunk or drinking problem I mean. A drinking problem where it's not really good for you. A good drinking problem I don't ever want to return to. It was what I would class as, for me, definite problem in that it wasn't good for me. It was not in the fact that the alcohol consumption itself was doing me any harm, but what happened when I got drunk, what sort of places it took me to in my mind, and things it made me feel about myself. And, you know, it was the first time I felt, I suppose I didn't even know I was depressed then, but obviously I was, because that was the first time that I felt suicidal about things. As I said, now I don't touch these things. I would have a glass if I was with somebody, but on my own, I could do one, maybe two of these sometime, but to be fair, probably two. Especially over Christmas period. I remember Christmas 88, 89, something like that. Two of these a night. And I didn't drive at the time, so my excuse nowadays not to drink is I drive. I can just say I only want a Coke or one beer, and that's a good reason for me not to want to drink. When I didn't drive, I had a bike or I walked, I could do two bottles of this. That would mean I could end up in some very dark places. Luckily, I had friends around me that sort of kept an eye on me. They knew that things weren't right. They could tell, like, you know, nobody consumes that much wine. Like at Christmas works party, there's five of us and somebody goes through three bottles of wine when the others don't get a chance. They were A, miffed that they didn't get the chance to drink the wine, and then they were like, well, where's he gone and what's he doing? But I'd have friends that would maybe come and rescue me and save me from self-destruction, I suppose, and save me from places that maybe I could have been very dangerous to myself. The edge of certain areas, you know, bridges, things like that, when I was absolutely blind drunk. One of the things I did when I was that down and that lonely was, unfortunately, I used to have a personal stereo, I used to have headphones, so I could ride my bike with my headphones in. And I used to have a tape back in the days before MP3s, had a tape with the Police on it. And there's a song that the Police do on the album. I can't remember what the album was, it's like Synchronicity or something like that. Or Greatest Hits. But anyway, the album had a song on it called I Can't Stand Losing. I kept playing that time and time and time again when I was drunk, which made me feel even worse and put me in a very bad place. Luckily, I said, I had friends pull me back from that. Some of the friends weren't exactly that much friends. They would do the dirty on me afterwards or at the same time. I didn't even know about it for years. But, you know, oh well. You learn lessons through life, I suppose. One of the things I have learned through life is I don't do this no more. I don't drink wine in quantity. I might drink a glass of wine at an event or a party. I'll drink a glass of Prosecco or even one of those little bottles of Prosecco. I could probably drink quite easily and quite nicely. It's quite a nice taste. Same goes for champagne. I do like champagne occasionally. If I ever get to go to people's weddings and things like that and invites, I will definitely drink a glass or two of champagne. My normal drinking habits, I will have maybe, you know, a vodka Red Bull or a glass of whiskey, but I never drink more than one measure, maybe two at the most. I never really go any stronger than that. Drinking excessively is something you need to get help with, and friends you need around you to stop you doing it. It puts you in a bad place. It's never a good solution to try and drink yourself out of something. Even if you feel fine at the time, you end up, I didn't do it to feel fine. Strange enough, I did it to feel worse, because then that would push me to drink or doing something else that maybe alleviate my problems. Obviously, in the end, it doesn't. What was why not this? I aren't going to get drunk by May on my own. I would if I was with somebody. I would, you know, we can have a couple of glasses and then get a stopper and put them in the fridge for another day. Or I would give them away as Christmas presents. At the moment, it's like a Christmas presents and birthday presents for people, because there are some very nice bottles there, but it probably tastes nice. I could drink them. I'm not against wine at all. It's just I'm against what happens when I drink wine. And that's the issue I have. I'm grateful for the wine that I'm given. It's brilliant. I do like the wine. It's very nice of people to give you gifts. Obviously, if they knew, then they probably wouldn't. But in some cases, it's just you don't want to refuse. So it's very nice that people give it to me. And as I said, I can give it away for presents and things like that. I don't get excited by it, though. Whereas, you know, something else comes along that I do get excited about is something strange and normal. Raspberry-flavoured Coke. Now, I'm not a fan of Coke Zero. Coke Zero, to be honest with you, it really is naff. But it's raspberry flavoured, so I'm going to try it. I won't try it tonight. I'll try it another day, and I will let you know. So that's, as you see, why I don't drink anymore, or not in major amounts anyway. This is the raspberry stuff. I did say to you, I'll try it. It's, you can smell the raspberry in it, but it doesn't really taste much. I think, if anything, it's more of a hint of raspberry in the flavour. But then again, that might be down to the zero as well. I think if it wasn't zero and had more sugar in it, it probably would taste a bit nicer. It would have a bit more flavour to it. But because it's sugar-free zero, it doesn't have much flavour at all to it. But that is my tipple for nowadays. Anyway, thanks for watching the vlog. I will get back to normal. I've got more ideas for other vlogs, as I said earlier in the other vlogs. Then please think about subscribing. If you do subscribe, hit the notification bell so you know when I upload more. If you're interested in watches, subscribe, because I've got my watch channel. And if you've got any comments, anything you want to suggest, anything you want to talk about wine, drinking, anything like that, or whatever else I review, then comment down below. I will reply, because I don't get a lot of comments, so I will reply to you, and we can have a chat. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.
I just call him Gizmo. He seems to like it.